za detsko učestvo. Nacionalna konferencija za detsko učestvo je prva od vakov tip v Republika Makedonija. I ja koristim je možnost da progovorime za detskite prava i detski aktivizam. Javno i direktno da kažeme deki nije detsata možeme da delujeme. Da go kažeme glasno naše to mislenje i toj glas da odekne široko vo našata zemlja, Republika Makedonija.
Денес смеламе, меѓу другото, да ги споделиме со вас искуствата со кои се добивме на тренинзите, работилниците и другите активности во изминатите 14 месеци, како дел од проектот «Градење култура на детско учество». Во следните 15 минути ќе ја проследиме проекцијата на филмот «Градење култура на детско учество», кој е изработен од децата учесници во проектот и се темели на нивните мислења и лични искуства. Па, ајде да го погледнеме.
Јас нема да ги искористам 10 минути, затоа што самиот филм кој го видовте говори многу. А предпочитам, кога има аргументи, велат и боговите молчат, така да нема што да кажам, освен дека сме завршили многу важна работа. Мислам дека Македонија е втора земја на Балканот, ако не и во Европа, која имаше детска делегација во Женева. Конкретно, јасно, го вклучивме детското учество, го слушавме детскиот глас, ги пренесовме детските препораки во извештај, објавени на страницата на КРИН и на невладината мрежа во Женева за алтернативни извештаи, извештаи во сенка, како ги нарекуваат. Владата ќе се помочи во мај да ги аргументира сите овие препораки што децата ги доставија и група на 23 граѓански организации во алтернативни извештаи. Се привикавме на факултативните протоколи. Значи, многу сериозна работа, благодарам на финансиерите Европска Унија и UNICEF за довербата. И не на најсоодветен начин, истата како што можете да забележите и во почетениот материјал и во видеозаписот ја исполнивме. Да се има прва детска амбасада во светот со ваков ентузијазам и добра воља е голема одговорност на владата, а децата многу ни помага да истраеме во наредните години за да може навистина детскиот активизам да биде уште поприсутен во сите институции и во училиштата, и во семејството, и таму каде што децата се движат, дават активно контрибуција, односно своје учество да се слушне гласот и да биде тоа практикуван. Се надам дека и оваа порака ќе ја прими Националната комисија за правата на детето, формирана од страна на владата на Република Македонија. Благодарам и ви сакувам активно учество и на оваа конференција.
Благодариме господине драги повелетелите на конференцијската маса. Дека го слушаме говорот на самите говорници.
А сега, почитувани гости, имаме можност да го слушаме говорот на амбасадорот на Европска Унија во Република Македонија, неговата екселенција господинот Ерван Пуере.
Почитувани гости, драги пријатели, драги деца, те да шур, ке ние, добро ден, мир дита. I want to say what a great pleasure it is for myself, my colleagues, and my also colleagues, representatives of the EU member states who are present here, thereby demonstrating the strong degree of solidarity that exists between the EU member states and Macedonia. I also want to say how happy we are to witness the conclusion of such a obviously very successful project. And we have seen here through the film that was shown just now, the many activities that brought all of you together and the many organizations who were working in this project. in a true spirit of partnership. And this is the spirit that we want to emphasize, and this is one of the reasons why the European Union provided financial support through the European Instrument for Democracy and Human Rights. And I also would like to express our deep appreciation to UNICEF, represented here, for their contribution to making this project possible. You all remember that last year the world celebrated the 20th anniversary of the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child, the most universally ratified human rights treaty. This convention is the first international legally binding instrument establishing minimum standards for the protection and safeguarding of a full range of civil, political, social, economic, and cultural rights of all children around the world. And we would recall the words of the then Vice President of the European Commission at the time, and these are words which I think we must repeat to ourselves every day. Children's rights are close to my heart. We must do everything we can to protect children and to allow them to develop their full potential so that they can become a force to reckon with in the future. So this anniversary that we celebrated also here in Skopje last year in the presence of President Ivanov was an opportunity not only to recognize the progress achieved in the promotion and protection of children's rights, but also to highlight and reflect on the many challenges still remaining and facing children in all countries around the world. Children's rights are a vital part and should be a vital part of any government's policies, and certainly play a vital role in the overall human rights policy of the European Union. It is a priority that we promote in our relations with all the countries around the world, and in particular with the countries who are aspiring to join the European Union. And of course, in order to achieve the objectives of promoting effectively human rights for the children, there are several instruments that the European Union has deployed over the years. And of course, we have provided significant financial support throughout the world in ensuring better respect for the rights of the children. In the context of the enlargement and those countries who are preparing to join the European Union, certainly this is one of the criteria for membership. Stability of the institutions, guaranteeing democracy, rule of law, human rights, and respect for and protection of minorities. And throughout the accession process, we monitor and promote the importance of child protection and progress on all issues relating to the rights of children. The European Forum, which is a forum based in Brussels on the rights of the child, aims to bring together all the main actors, member states, representatives, ombudspersons for children, representatives of all the different EU institutions, Council of Europe, UNICEF, and civil society organizations. And this forum plays a vital role in advising the EU institutions on how to strengthen our support and protection for the rights of the child. And in addition, this year's European Union non-governmental organization Human Rights Forum was specifically devoted to discussing children's rights. It is evident that policies addressing children's rights are multiple and multidimensional, but I think we would emphasize three in particular, and they were reflected in the film that we just saw. Social inclusion and the fight against poverty, anti-discrimination, and child participation. And certainly, children living in difficult economic circumstances, or children who are unable to live at home for various reasons, and who are exposed to poverty, exclusion, and discrimination, these are children that we need to cater for. Also, children who suffer disproportionately from environmental degradation, Every child living in neglect on our streets is a picture of a violation of fundamental rights. We cannot look away. We cannot ignore the fact that a child is suffering. And we cannot ignore the consequences: lack of education, marginalization, exclusion, unemployment, poverty. That's why we need to break this cycle of poverty. So children's participation in this respect is vital. Children have an important stake in the outcome of policy decisions, but of course they have little power to shape them. They do not vote, and they cannot directly represent their own interests in governing bodies. Their ability to influence policies is limited, and this is why the various activities that you organized and the meetings with the parliamentary committee and so on, these are all excellent examples of making the decision makers, the politicians, realize the importance of discussion with representatives of children's organizations to make sure that their rights, their views and their rights are fully taken into account. Fighting against child poverty must focus on education, housing, family, culture and sports, because children discrimination starts in their early life through education and access to goods and services. And local communities is the first place where children must, whose views must be taken into account. For all of these challenges, the local communities and the institutions at the national level can and must make a difference by listening to the children and taking into account their rights while designing the policies. So we will continue in our work in the European Union to focus on these priority themes.